Inhale with Steve Ross.
Welcome to Inhale. Stand up. We're going to do some yoga. Or you are, anyway. Step the feet wide apart. Hang all the way forward. Just hang. You don't have to pull yourself down unless you want to. Relax your neck. Breathe through the nose now and through the whole class, if possible. Or if you're very advanced, you can hold your breath now and exhale at the end of the class. Just stay here. Make sure your neck is relaxed. Tendency is to tense it up a little. And you can interlock the hands behind your back and drop them over your head if you want, which you do. Nowhere to go. And bring the hands down to the floor. Roll all the way up. Step the feet together. Bring the palms together in prayer pose. Inhale, arch up. Reach up. And exhale, come all the way forward. Bring the hands flat down on the floor. If you have to bend the knees to do that, that's okay. Lift the head up, pull the chest away from the legs, jump back or step back, top of a push-up. Stay there for a moment. Very slowly, keeping the elbows in by the ribs, sink down toward the floor. Inhale and arch up into the upward facing dog. Make sure your legs are straight. Ideally, you'd be on the tops of the feet, legs off the floor, arms straight. See if you can push the chest forward and pull the shoulders down and back. You can also drop the head back if you want. Next time you exhale, push back into a downward facing dog. Walk the feet in a little toward the hands if you need to. Keep pushing away with the hands. The fingers are spread wide apart so you get a nice wide base. But it won't last long. Jump the feet up to the hands or step them up if you have to. Roll all the way up, stretch up. You can always go back, arching back a little bit if you want to, but you don't have to. Not yet. Exhale, come all the way forward. Passing up. Hands down, head up. Jump back or step back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, down dog. Raise the left arm straight up in the air. Turn completely to the side. The hips are high, the legs are straight. You can have one foot in front of the other or one on top of the other if you like that better. If this is too much, you can always bring the right knee down like that. Support the weight. Yeah.
I know I'm late.
10 more minutes. And come down. If you can do an actual push-up, do it. If not, just go straight over to the other side. One day I will do it for 10 more minutes. Exactly. Oh, look. You guys are together. Help me. Okay, bring the hand down. Slowly, with some kind of illusion of control, come down. I'll take you there. Arch up, upward dog. Exhale and push back into the downward facing dog. Relax your neck here. Keep pushing the heels and chest down, flattening the back as much as you can. Jump both feet up to the hands, or step them. Bring the arms up in the air, bend the legs. Chair pose, first one of 1,000. You can drop the head back, bring the palms together if you want, or can. Try to keep the feet and knees together. All right, bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Lift the head, jump back or step back. Come down and up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Raise the right leg up in the air, push the left heel down. You can roll the hip open if you want. Swing the foot up, come into a crescent pose. Make sure the back leg is very straight. Some variations of this pose, they turn the back foot down flat. If you like that variation better, it's okay, but otherwise stay on the ball of the back foot. Keep the arms straight. Look happy. Happy, smiling faces. Yeah. And bring the hands to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Left leg up in the air this time. Right heel pushing down. If it touches the floor, keep pushing it into the floor. If it doesn't, doesn't matter. Keep pushing it in that direction. As a variation, you can take the left leg and kind of bend it and drop it behind you a little bit. If you want to. And swing the foot up into a crescent pose. You can do this and sing along. It disproves the theory you can only do one thing at a time. To the floor, step the foot back. Sink down at your own speed, which is always lightning fast. Inhale and arch up, up dog. Exhale and push back, downward dog. Stay here, sink the chest. And jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose, arms up in the air, bend the legs. You guys are awfully quiet today. It's all right. And bring the hands to the floor, straighten the legs. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back maybe a little bit. And exhale, come all the way forward. Just hang there. We'll be back very soon for more Inhale on Oxygen. Stay tuned to Inhale. And we're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. If you're gonna go back to any large degree, squeeze the butt tight to protect your low back. And exhale, come all the way forward. Hands flat, down. Lift the head, pull the chest away from the legs, jump or step back. Come down at your own speed. I'll just leave it at that. Arch up, up dog, I give up. Push back, down, dog. Right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose again. Back leg straight. From here, slowly lean out over the front leg. Come on up into the balance pose, arms either in front of you or behind you, whichever you prefer. Sink the chest though, raise the left leg at least level to the floor. You can always sink the chest lower and raise the leg higher. You feel like you're gonna fall, grab the person next to you, take them down. You can take out the whole row. It's a good feeling. And bring the hands to the floor, leg up in the air into the standing splits. Try to keep both legs straight as you can. If you need more, you can grab the back of the standing leg, in this case the right one, and pull the forehead in toward the shin. What's going on? Keeping the right fingertips on the floor, raise the left arm straight up in the air. Try to roll the chest and stomach and left hip open. Into the half moon pose. Okay, bring it down, feet together, hands down. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little. Exhale, come forward. Lift the head, jump back. Come on down. And up. And back, down, dog. Left leg up in the air this time. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose. Other side, same thing. Balance pose. Lean out. Come on up. Some people like it better with the arms behind. That's okay. Just go slow. Take your time. Neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preach up. For God shall wipe away. Yes, sir. Every tear from their eye. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution. Come on. Come on. What you say? Come on. Do you want a revolution? Good balancing music. Hands out, leg up, standing split. Do you want a revolution? Come on, do you want a revolution? Sick and tired of my brothers killing each other. Sick and tired of daddies leaving babies with their mothers. To every man that wants to lay around and play around. Listen, partner, you've been mad enough to stay around. Sick and tired of the church talking religion. When you only talk about each other, make a decision. Right arm up in the air this time. Left fingertips or fingers or hand on the floor. Gotta roll the hip open, ribs, stomach, chest open. I say, do you want a revolution? you've got this down pretty well, you can start to look up. Come on down. Feet together, hands down. Bring the arms up in the air, bend the legs, chair pose. They're grooving. Finally. Hands down. Legs straight. Lift the head, jump back or step back. Come down. And push up, up dog with an inhale, hopefully. Exhale and push back, downward dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. So enough of that. Swing the foot up. Turn the back foot flat down. Interlock the hands behind your back. Bring the head down toward the floor to the inside of the front foot into the lunge, deep as you can go. Make sure the back foot is very flat. To the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. And up. And push back. Down, down. Raise the left leg up in the air. Swing it up. Straight into the lunge, other side. Turn the right foot flat this time. Again, interlock the hands. You can kind of pull the shoulders back and then come down. Low. How low? If your head's on the floor, don't put too much weight on it. That would be cheating. We don't want to cheat, I'm sure. And bring the hands down to the floor, step the foot back. Sing down. Arch up. And push back, down doggy. Not the down kitty.
Down doggy.
Jump both feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back if you want, don't if you don't. Exhale, come all the way forward. And just hang forward. There's more warm up when we return on inhale. Stay tuned to inhale. And we're back for more yoga on inhale. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Arch back if you want to. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands are down, head is up. Jump back or step back. Just a little more of this part. Come on down. Inhale and arch up. Stay here. Take a few deep breaths here. See if you can push the chest forward, pulling the shoulders down, and ideally back. Next time you exhale, push back into the downward facing dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. And make it Swing the foot up. Turn the left foot flat down. Interlock the hands behind your back. Drop the interlocked hands over your head as you bring the head down toward the floor. Close as you can. Make sure the back foot is very flat. If you don't feel much, slide the back foot back a little bit farther. Andrew's coming apart. And bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come all the way down. And arch up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Left leg up in the air this time. Swing it up. Other side, same thing. Turn the right foot flat this time. Interlock the hands behind you, come down. If that's too intense, just bring the hands down to the inside of the left foot or forearm. Keep bending the right leg as much as you can. If you can rest your head on the floor, that makes it so much easier. Okay, bring the hands down, step it back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. Push back, down dog. You sure you want to continue or you'd rather stop, get some cappuccino? Hard to tell. Looks like a cappuccino vote. Jump both feet up to the hands. And then jump them right back. What are you doing? Come down. Hurry. Arch up. Up dog. Push back. Down dog. Right leg in the air.
Do some rapping. So heavy D.
Yes, sir.
I need your help, man.
Gotcha. I got you.
Swing the foot up into a crescent pose. Once you're there, you can do a little modification. Bring the arms out wide, drop the head back, or even arch back. If your balance is not really great at this moment for whatever reason, don't do that part. Slowly bring the hands together. And then hook the left elbow over the front leg into a prayer-style twist. Or you can bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air. If you want a more or less easier variation, you can bring the left hand down to the inside of the right foot and twist open that way. Pluck your strings like they never been plucked. Strum you to sleep, so tell me what's up. I like how you shine. Would you be mine? State your case over my place. So take some time. I love that line. Fly with me. What's the matter, Lucy? Oh, you're loyal to be me. I understand. He got the upper hand. Keep it calm. After all, he's been fondling you for years. You know. Keep it calm. Bring the hands to the floor. I'm back off. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. I think I'll rest. I'm getting tired just watching. Left leg up in the air.
We are, right? Yeah. Just leave it on in there. I feel good. It's kind of fun for me.
Me too. Well, swing good. The foot up. Crescent pose first. Again, the arms can be wide out or not.
She's starting to feel good here. Lucille didn't know she'd ever do any rapping at all. But you know, she loses control when she gets around guys like you. All right.
And bring the hands together. Hook the right elbow this time. Straighten the back leg as much as you can. See if you can point the left elbow toward the ceiling. rolling the right shoulder under. Make sure the stance is fairly wide so you can bend that front leg. And bring the hand down, step the foot back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, down dog. We're not done yet. Right leg up in the air.
Just keep on wrapping.
Swing the foot up to the hands. Come immediately into the warrior two. Turn the back foot flat. Turn to the side. Arms are level to the floor. Look out over the right fingertips. Kind of lift the chest a little bit. Make sure the right leg is at a right angle or as close as you can get it. You want the right knee directly over the right angle. Ankle and angle. Bring the right hand to the floor, left arm up in the air. Oops. Habits die hard. Keep rolling the chest open as much as you can.
So she took her love for to gaze a while.
Reach underneath the front leg with the right arm. Grab the left hand or wrist behind your back. Just for a second, just for a second. It's a long second. Okay, bring the hands down, step the foot back. Come down. And arch up. And push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing it up to the hands. Right into the warrior, other side. Turn the right foot down this time.
Feel her body rise when you kiss her mouth among the fields of gold.
Everyone looks very intense. Bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air. And reach underneath and grab the right hand or wrist or fingers behind you. That's enough. Bring the hands down, step the foot back. Sink down slowly. Inhale, arch up, up dog. Bring the knees to the floor and push back into the child's pose. We'll be back for more yoga on Oxygen. Stay tuned to Oxygen Media. And we're back, more or less. So we're gonna do a few back bends just to see what happens to you. Slide the feet up towards the butt. Feet are about hip distance apart and flat down. You can grab the ankles from the outside, maybe. Push the hips up in the air high as you can into the bridge pose. Kind of tuck the pelvis under so the low spine is opening. Once you're up, if you want, you can interlock the hands on the floor underneath you. Or if you're feeling truly lazy, you can bring the hands underneath the hips or waist and do a supported variation. Or if you're a show-off, like Andrew, you can come up into the wheel. If you're in the wheel, try and straighten the arms. You can always walk the hands and feet closer together. This works the whole spine, obviously, and also the shoulders. When you've had enough of this, slowly come down. Pull the knees into the chest.
Vice versa, come on and get it.
I'm not touching you. Let's try that one more time. At least. Come on, your enthusiasm is contagious. When you're ready, all the way up into the fabulous bridge or wheel. Try to keep the feet straight. If the feet turn out, it's okay, but it's much better for your spine to keep the feet straight. Breathe very deep. If you focus on the breath, you'll hardly notice the intense intensity of the sensation in your spine, shoulders, wherever it is. And slowly come down. Pull the knees in again. Then straighten the legs on the floor and roll over on your tummy. I'm going to do it. Actually, you are. Bend the knees. Grab the ankles from the outside. Universally hated position. The bow. Keeping the arms straight, you try and straighten the legs away from you, which will pull you up. If your hip bones dig into the floor, that's appropriate. Breathe while you're here. If you're a girl, you can rock back and forth. If you want to be a girl, you can rock back and forth. It's up to you. It's all about choice. All right, come down. Relax, turn your head to one side or the other. If you're watching at home, these people are extremely tired and hating me. That's why one more won't make that much difference. So, come on up. They say this opens the spine, stretches the thighs, gets rid of any excess. No, it doesn't get rid of anger, it causes anger. Gets rid of any excess, how do you say it? Weight around the middle. Tires, yeah, gets rid of the tires. That's apparently enough, so come down. A fabulous job. From here, push back into a child's pose just for a moment, depending on what kind of childhood you had. And then sit up, turn around, sit between the feet, and then lie back as far as you can go. Now, there's a cool little trick. According to the yogis, everything in the universe is composed of five elements: earth, water, fire, air, and space. Ether, they call it. So, according to these same yogis, in the body, there's also those same elements, obviously, since everything has got that, made out of that. So if you take, and they also say the fingers represent the different elements, earth being the grossest, the thumb, water being the index finger, fire being the darting, being the longest finger, the middle finger, the ring finger, air, and the subtlest, space, or ether, being the little finger. So if you take the middle fingers and you put them in the navel, right in the belly button, while you're in this pose, supposedly, that connects to the solar center in your abdomen and actually increases your, or improves your digestion. That's what they say. And even if it doesn't work, it looks cool. And you have a whole philosophy so you can feel very spiritual. In the Western culture, the middle finger is generally used for some other kind of salutes. Also fiery in nature, often. All right, that's enough digestion improvement. Come on up slowly. Again, turn around, try not to get dizzy. This time, bring the soles of the feet together. Usually we pull them in close, but this time bring them out a little ways so that if you were to come down, your face would be more or less in your feet. And just come all the way down as far as you can. Stretches the hips, obviously, but when the feet are out that way, you also get some of the back of the thighs and some of the lower back. It intensifies the decompression of the low spine, which gets very compressed if you sit all day, like about 99% of all people do, especially in hard furniture. If you sit on a nice, soft sofa and flip the channels, then you'll really get depressed as well as compressed. That's a whole other story. Just stay here and breathe. Slow, deep breaths. If your attention wanders, just keep bringing your attention back into the room, into this moment. You can always focus on the sensation to help that happen. Slowly, come on up. Turn around again. And this time, lie down on your back. Once you get there, just kind of spread out. We're gonna hang here for a few minutes. Some people consider this the best part of the whole thing. Eyes are gently closed. Take a slow, deep breath. And we'll be back very shortly for more deep relaxation on Inhale. You're watching Inhale. And we're back. If you've been doing yoga with us, this is the time to relax. If you're just joining us, you can relax anyway. Just spread out, lie flat on your back, which most of you are already doing. Turn the palms up. Make sure the face is very relaxed, the jaw, the lips are slightly parted, tongue is relaxed, cheeks are relaxed, all the little muscles around the eyes, very soft. Forehead is broad and flat and relaxed. If there's any area in your body that feels tense or is pulling your attention to it, acknowledge it, be aware of it. Include it in your moment. Rather than resisting it, you can try welcoming it. Just include it in the area that is already relaxed and it will become absorbed, and you can get very expanded and very open. Some people like to do a kind of guided imagery. If you're one of those, you can inhale very deep and slow, and as you do, you're inhaling love and bliss and joy and happiness and relaxation, and as you exhale, you let go of any tension or stress or fear or worry. If you do this a few times and then drop it, it's a nice practice. Very slowly, allow your attention to come back a little bit. Take a long, slow breath. Don't strain, make it leisurely and easy. And exhale it. With the eyes still closed, gently roll to one side. And then come up into a sitting position whenever you can. Eyes are closed still. Just be as open to this moment as possible. The normal human condition is to be chronically at warfare, chronically resistant to what is. But in this moment, see if you can transcend that and just be present, accepting whatever is the case. And if you can, happiness is a function of that kind of acceptance, and you'll start to feel very good. And bring the palms together. Namaste.